So, you have a girl you're into. Maybe you've been talking a bit, but you're not quite at the stage where you're comfortable with her and got it in the bag. But you know one thing for certain, you don't want to fuck things up. In this video, I'm going to show you the four things you should never, and I mean never, say to a girl, because if you do, your chances with her are as good as dead. If any of these things come out of your mouth, they are a one-way ticket to Tier 1 Simphood. And the most action you'll get will be complaining on Reddit to other neckbeards about girls not liking you. Alright, number one, don't lie to her. Sounds pretty obvious, but this probably sounds a little strange coming from a playboy like me, but most guys think every good ladies' man lies to all his mistresses. But that's a rookie mistake. Here's why. When you lie to a woman, she loses respect for you. And if a woman doesn't respect you, she won't date you, she won't stay with you long term, and she'll look for reasons to leave you. Women are only attracted to men they respect. You don't ever see a girl gush over a dude she doesn't respect, do you? Yeah, me either. And that's just the practical side of things. If you're lying often, you should ask yourself, why would you want to lie to your partner? If you can't even be honest and tell the truth to the person you're dating or want to date, then are they really the right person for you? Are you doing things you're ashamed of? I've dated women and told them I'm dating and even sleeping with other women before, and been totally 100% honest about it. Did the women like what I'm telling them? No, they didn't like it, but they didn't run away either because I was upfront, honest, and we weren't exclusive at the time. By being truthful to them, their respect for me remained intact. I didn't beat around the bush, lie, or omit things to make me look better or hide what I was doing. A man who hides is a man who's insecure in his actions and character. Does insecure and floppy character sound attractive to you? No. If a woman knows she can trust you, she knows that no matter what, at all times, no matter how bad things are, she can always rely on you to tell her the truth. That foundation of reliability and trust is everything in a healthy relationship. It creates peace of mind because you never have to worry or do the mental stress of wondering whether your partner is lying to you. Number two, don't overhype yourself. Most guys try to overhype themselves, their size, their bedroom skills, and all types of stuff, and it really works out bad for a few reasons. One, you create expectations, and once you set expectations for something, it's almost impossible to live up to them. The last thing you want is to disappoint her the first time you guys meet. Two, it's better to be mysterious and fun and let her find out how badass you are when the time is right and wow her with it then. The fact she doesn't know what to expect will make you that much better. And anticipation is the root of romantic tension. Every guy does this. They try to impress the girl and oversell themselves. It just makes you seem corny and like everybody else. She's seen this trick played before time and time again. And even if you are really that great, 9 times out of 10, the girl just straight up won't believe you because she's heard it all before from every guy that came before you. So, you're really just wasting your breath. And between you and me, I know so many girls who've told me stories of guys who talked a big game just to finish in like 10 seconds. It's like, geez, nice going, bro. Remember, it's not a job interview. Don't tell her why you're the right fit. Show her. Number three, don't be a circus clown. A lot of guys put on an act when they're around women. They think they have to act or be a certain way to keep the girl interested. Understand this, my disciple. You're not a fucking clown, okay? Your intentions are not a performance. It's not supposed to be, hey, look at me, pay attention to me. A lot of guys take the idea of getting the girl interested and impressing her to the extreme, and it results in them essentially becoming a clown, and I mean that literally. They begin to act like it's their job to entertain her, keep her interests at all costs, and every single action and things they do revolve around keeping her attention focused on them. And this screws a lot of guys over because then they make it their goal to entertain the girl rather than build a genuine connection. Remember, you want her to be interested in you romantically. And you want to be screening her throughout because you want to make sure she's the right fit for you and the type of girl you're looking for. Number four, don't filter yourself. Okay, if you're not willing to lose the girl, you won't be able to do what's necessary to win her either. Guys overthink and get stuck in their heads because they're overanalyzing every little thing they want to say. Dude, remember, dating is supposed to be fun, not more stress. You want a girl you can have fun with, not a girl who feels like a chore to be around. Don't be so afraid of not being the right fit for some girls. Hey, you never know. She may have a friend that's smoking hot that loves guys like you. Trying to fit in and be like everyone else results in you doing just that, being like everyone else, and that's a problem. When you speak your mind, you might make the girl feel uncomfortable at first, but it's really just her being thrown off by your candidness. Most often, the girl will readjust once the shock effect of what you said wears off and she knows what to expect from you. Disclaimer: this doesn't mean to be intentionally shocking or polarizing or try to be flashy. It just means just say how you feel and what comes to mind. Too much time in your head filtering yourself on what you think she wants to hear will pull you out of the conversation and make you miss opportunities. In the modern era, if you want to communicate that you're a high-value man, the fastest and most effective way to do so is with your Instagram profile. It does a lot of the talking for you, and it can get multiple girls interested in you without you having to lift a finger because the profile does 90% of the work. I know! Sweet, huh? With your Instagram profile alone, you can convey tons of social value to the girl before you even meet her in person. Just by posting a specific set of stories, captions, and photos, you can trigger intense attraction and familiarity with the women who come across your profile. You'll have them dying to meet you. I call this the influencer effect. Oh, Zeus, I want to be that. Well, of course you do. Everybody wants to be an influencer. Our newest course, Instagame, is our copy-paste system for turning you from average to influencer and turning your Instagram profile into the best dating app in the world. Inside, Benjamin and I show you how to copy and paste templates for you to write captivating captions that make women melt, post stories that make women reply and ask you to hang out, and the exact poses for you to use in your pictures to make you look as attractive as possible. So what I'm saying is, a picture of you dumpster diving is probably not the one to use. We'll tell you the right ones. It even comes with a Facebook coaching group with hundreds of guys giving each other real-time feedback and help with their specific profiles. And yes, Benjamin and I are in there daily giving advice and helping you guys crush it on Instagram. So if you want to learn exactly how to do this, click the link in the description and let's get started. The program comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so if you don't like the course for any reason, just let us know and you'll get 100% of your money back. It's a no-brainer. Man, we're living in 2021 now. The most attractive girls aren't wasting time on Tinder. They're on Instagram. Hey, it's time you started dating them. Oh, the best is yet to come. Zeus out.